What if I told you our entire galaxy is surfing a cosmic tsunami right now, and you are on it? What would happen if something crashed into the Milky Way so hard it sent shockwaves across the galaxy? Well, it already did. The European Space Agency's Gaia telescope has been tracking billions of stars, mapping their exact positions and speeds. And what they found is absolute chaos. Picture the Milky Way as a vinyl record spinning in space. Now imagine someone dropped a bowling ball right through it. That's essentially what happened. This wave spanned 65,000 light years. That's 382 quintillion miles. To put that in perspective, if you traveled at the speed of light from New York to LA, you'd make that trip 78 billion times before crossing this wave. But here's where it gets wild. Stars aren't just sitting in this wave, they're moving. Millions of them rising and diving hundreds of light years above and below the galactic plane. The data shows it perfectly. Red zones where stars are pushed above the disk, blue zones where they're pressed below, like a massive stadium wave, but instead of drunk fans, it's entire solar systems. And guys, we've been blind to this our entire existence, until now. So what could possibly create a wave this massive? This is where things get insane. Scientists think a dwarf galaxy, possibly the Sagittarius dwarf galaxy, passed through the Milky Way in the past and gravitationally disturbed our galactic disk. Like a cannonball hitting a swimming pool, it sent ripples across hundreds of billions of stars. This cosmic ripple has been propagating for hundreds of millions of years, possibly since before dinosaurs existed on Earth. But wait, there's another theory that's even crazier. Some scientists think the wave started from inside our galaxy. Massive gas clouds colliding, creating a chain reaction that spread outward like dominoes. Except each domino is a billion stars. The young stars in the wave are the smoking gun. They formed recently, astronomically speaking, which means this wave is still active. It's not some ancient fossil. It's alive, moving, reshaping our galaxy right now. Think about that. While you're sitting there, our entire solar system is potentially riding this wave up and down through the galaxy. We're cosmic surfers, and we didn't even know it. But here's the question nobody's asking. Is this wave dangerous for Earth? Our sun takes 230 million years to orbit the galaxy once. During that journey, we actually do bob up and down through the galactic plane. Scientists call it galactic oscillation. But this new wave, it's different. The wave could be adding extra vertical motion to our solar system. Imagine driving on a highway that suddenly becomes a roller coaster. That's potentially what's happening to us. Although this is speculative because scientists do not yet know if our solar system is part of the wave. Now, don't panic. The movements are slow. We're talking thousands of miles per hour through space. That sounds fast, but at cosmic scales, it's like watching grass grow. You won't feel it. Your coffee won't spill. This discovery is reshaping our understanding. The Milky Way isn't unique. If our galaxy has this wave, others probably do too. Andromeda, our nearest neighbor that's heading straight for us, it might be surfing its own waves. Here's what blows my mind. This wave might affect star formation. When gas and stars compress in the wave crests, they create stellar nurseries. New stars might be being born because of this tsunami. And some of those stars might have planets. Some of those planets might have life. That life might exist because a galaxy crashed into ours hundreds of millions of years ago. We're not just riding the wave. We might exist because of it. But this is all speculation at this point. The Gaia telescope is still collecting data. They've only analyzed a fraction of what's up there. There could be multiple waves, crossing patterns, interference zones where waves amplify each other. Our galaxy might be more like an ocean than a disk. And we've only just discovered the first wave. Scientists are racing to figure out three critical things. When exactly did the event that triggered the wave happen? If they can date the wave, they can identify which dwarf galaxy was the culprit. There's actually a list of suspects, and the Sagittarius dwarf galaxy is prime candidate number one. And then can we use this wave to find dark matter? The wave's behavior might reveal invisible mass affecting its movement. We could literally surf our way to solving the universe's biggest mystery. So here is what we now know. Something disturbed our galaxy on a massive scale, likely a past interaction with a smaller dwarf galaxy, and it sent a ripple through the Milky Way more than 60,000 light years across. This wave is moving through the galaxy right now, carrying billions of stars with it. Our solar system may even be part of this motion as we slowly rise and fall through the galactic disk. The Milky Way is not a calm, flat spiral like we once imagined. It is dynamic, restless, and constantly evolving. We are not just drifting through space, we are riding a cosmic wave. And here is the wild part. This may only be the first wave we have detected. There could be more ripples, more distortions, even overlapping waves still hidden in the galaxy. If you want to see just how intense galactic collisions can get, click on our video about the upcoming collision between the Milky Way and Andromeda. Because if a small dwarf galaxy can create a wave this massive, imagine what happens when two full-sized galaxies collide head-on.